My name is Katiee, and my best friend of 4.5 years has alopecia. Life was hard growing up for her because she spent many years being bullied by other children because she was different and did not have hair. Let's fast forward to high school. My senior year, her freshman year. It was the best of times and the worst of times. Best of times because I met my best friend of now going on 5 years. The worst of times became of what she had to endure from those people during those years and still experiences at times even to this day. The bullying and the whispers of the kids pointing and laughing and sneering as she walked by were very hard. Hard for her to experience and hard for me as a friend to see because I knew how much it hurt her, even though she always try to put on a brave face. Some of the boys would laugh and call her names and try to pull off her wig and just be jerks. But mostly the girls were the worst because they were quiet about it. They would smile to her face, act like they were friends, then as soon as she walked off, there were collective giggles. To this day, there are still people who look at her as if she's doing something wrong by betraying an image of beauty and self-confidence. As if instead she should just quietly fade into the background. I applaud my friend for her courage to find comfort in her own skin and to be a voice and an advocate for others. Now let me tell you a little bit about alopecia. Alopecia is a condition that causes a person's hair to fall out. Alopecia is an autoimmune disease where a person's immune system attacks the body and in this case the hair follicles. When this happens, the person's hair begins to fall out, often in clumps the size and shape of a quarter. The extent of the hair loss varies. In some cases, it's only a few spots. In others, the hair loss can be greater. Alopecia is an unpredictable disease. In some cases, hair grows back but falls out again later. Others, hair can grow back and remain. Each case is unique, just like every person is unique. Even if someone loses all of his or her hair, there is a chance it will grow back. Who gets alopecia, you ask? Anyone can develop alopecia. However, your chances of having alopecia are slightly greater if you have a relative with the condition. In addition, alopecia occurs more often among people who have family members with autoimmune disorders, such as diabetes, lupus, or thyroid disease. Can alopecia be cured? Unfortunately, it cannot be cured. However, it can be treated and the hair can grow back. Now, the real reason why I'm telling you all of this is because I wanted to find a way to surprise her for her graduation. Her time has come. She finally made it. She graduated high school. She's always been there for me, no matter what, through thick and thin. I've donated my hair 5 times in total. The last time I got my hair cut, she was with me, and of course it was given to her. But this time is my time to surprise her, get my hair cut, and present my present to her. She won't be seeing this video until her graduation party, and at this point she'll probably be beginning to cry and looking at me as I pull off a wig of my own to show that my hair is now short and hand her a box with the ponytail of my hair to put towards her next wig. I love you, Alexandra Jane. I'll always be here. I will forever be your senior, your best friend, your puff cake, your big sister. Congratulations, you made it. Class of 2015. 4.5 years of friendship down, and many, many more to come.